In 1991, the 4x4 team going into the final was really, really buoyant. All of us individuals who were good at what we did. John Regis, European champion, 200 metres. Roger Black, European champion, 400 metres. Derek Redmond, British record holder, 400 metres. Akabisi, the main man. Well, not easy, not quite the main man. But European champion, 400 metre hurdles. Great friends, great athletes.
The team's just about to be announced. Will this gamble pay off?
You know, originally Roger Black should be fourth leg runner because at the time he was the silver medalist at the World Championships. But we knew we had to be in contention with the Americans. So from the first leg to the last leg, you have to give the man a chance to perform.
The wind freshening as they get away, and Roger Black in lane number three goes straight away, closes right down on the Jamaican.
We know the fastest man in the world, arguably, was going to be running last leg. So we thought, if we can stick Roger on first and he puts us up there with the Americans, at least we've only got three legs to try and hold them as opposed to having four legs.
For me on the line, it was quite simple. Run as fast as you can, give us a lead. Give it to Derek Redmond, who can either extend that lead or at least we'd be in contention. At least the Americans would have something to think about. Give it on the third leg to Big John Regis, stuck up behind an American. Now, if you've got Big John Regis with his little ears, his huge nostrils and his two chests up your backside for 400 metres, you will not be thinking about your running style. So he then hands it over to Chris Akabusi on the last leg, also stuck behind an American, laughing in his ear all the way around the track. Method behind our madness.
Black has done a good one, but so too has Valman.
I can remember Roger coming down the home straight, and because it's a 500 metre stagger, I knew we were roughly in the lead. And I just remember thinking, take the baton and get the hell out of there.
At the handoff point, well, it's very close between America and Great Britain, but I think Great Britain have just got the edge.
Going down the home straight, he happened to go past me. I mean, I'd give it everything I got. He was a bit stronger, he went past me, and I just thought, just hang on to him, don't let him open up a gap.
Quincy Watts has got America right back in, and has the British gamble failed?
A lot of people would think, you know, why is a 200-metre man in a 4x4 relay team? Purely and simply because, you know, I was put in the team to do a specific job. My job was to keep in contact with the third leg runner from the US. There actually came a point down the back straight where I actually thought I could have run past, I think the athlete was Danny Everett, because I felt that strong, that confident and that euphoric.
I remember saying to Johnny, before we got on the track, Regis, don't give me that baton 2 metres up, either 10 up or 2 behind.
So I thought, I don't think I'll give him 10 metres, I'll tuck back in and do my job. And fortunately, I did that.
And all of a sudden, I've got to deliver.
America will take over in the lead with their world champion pedigree on the anchor leg. Akabusi goes after him.
What gave me real confidence about being able to run the last leg against the world champion Antonio Pettigrew was the fact that all year I trained with the silver medalist Roger Pretty Boy Black on our track in Southampton. And now Roger ran Pettigrew really close. I'd run Roger close on many occasions, not often, but many occasions in our training sessions. And I knew that if Roger could be that close, so could I.
Now, Akabusi has got to sit there and wait and make a late attack if he can.
I'm running after Pettigrew, nick, down the back straight. And let me tell you what I was thinking. Pettigrew, you're jogging.
If Chris got to 200, I thought we could win this.
Time stood still. We're jogging. I look up, there's a big screen. What's going on? Are they catching us? No. Nick, into the home straight.
This is an important point. Can Akabusi do it?
I thought, we could really, really win this.
Akabusi has a go.
I fly past Pettigrew. I know I'm going to win until about 10 minutes to go. When all of a sudden, my gosh, I'm ahead of Pettigrew. We can do it.
And then Pettigrew started to come back again, and I thought, oh, no, it's gone.
And he's fighting back.
My legs start wobbling.
I said, come on, Chris, come on.
Akabusi has made it.
Bam, we crossed that line. Fantastic.
I said, we're world champions. We're world champions. We're world champions.
Let me tell you what was going through my head when I crossed the line straight after the 1991 World Championships. Derek Redmond. He jumps on me, he mugs me, man. He's all over my head.
And the poor lad had just run his life off and he's got me jumping on his back, so.
And all of a sudden, I see a great big shadow. Johnny, two chest regions, vroom!
I didn't see Chris cross the line. As soon as he did, I saw Brendan Foster and go crazy. So I jumped up, turned around, and then I just lost it.
Now, Roger Black, he's quite an understated, sellable character. Yeah!
Goal for Britain, America second. And the gamble paid off.
Every 4x4 in the history of the event, first on top of the list, USA. And then for them to actually end up with silver medal, to them was absolute failure.
Yeah, we're all there, hands in the air, sort of waving to everybody, and you look down, you see some stone-faced Americans there who don't look too happy, then it was like, this is ours.
But the bottom line was, on the day, we delivered, because we were confident, but we weren't complacent.
And it doesn't happen very often, but if you dare to win, and you're brave enough to do something different and take a risk, you can achieve the ultimate.